The Pink Ribbonettes, a support group for breast cancer survivors, hosts the 10th annual Pink Ribbon Tea. Today on the front page, we learn more about this annual event.
This is the 10th annual Pink Tea that we have done. We started very, very small, going out and begging people for donations so that we could have food. And we've come a long way. The major part of the food today is donated by Cumberland Village. And the purpose of this tea is to, my say is, to celebrate and educate. And one of the things we want to do is to encourage ladies, men too, if they feel the need, to get a mammogram and to be ever diligent in checking for unusual things going on in the breast. And of course, October is Breast Cancer Awareness Month, and that is one of the reasons why the tea is placed in this month. It has changed quite a lot. And some of the ladies that we worked with very diligently, of course, have not been with us now. But it was mostly because they had lived a long, fruitful life, and they had taken care of themselves. And in the Pink Ribbonettes, we try to encourage the ladies and men. We've had a man before in our group. We do not do any kind of medical advice or any kind of dietary. We just try to say, you know, I've been through what you're going through, and you can make it. There is light at the end of the tunnel. You can make it. So that's our Pink Ribbonette group. And the Pink Ribbonette group, of course, is, especially this year, the planner and whole organizational body for the Pink Tea. I'm hoping that this, like I say, will encourage people to be ever diligent in checking for abnormal situations that might have something to do with breast cancer. And not just breast cancer, but be on the lookout, be aware of your body and what is the way that it should be and unusual things. Be diligent, proactive, and check. I would just like to thank everybody that has reached out and helped us in the Pink Tea, in the Pink Ribbonettes, in our lives. You know, the medical situation, the medical students here from Aiken Technical College, they set up such wonderful displays with all the aspects of breast cancer. So I'm just really overwhelmed with how much help we've had. And the speaker today is Rebecca Robinson, and she has done a wonderful job of putting things together in regards to that.
We'll be back after a quick commercial break.
Everyone's a welcome guest at Crescent Automotive. We're Aiken's Choice Award winner 4 years in a row.
That probably has a lot to do with our low upfront windshield pricing and no additional processing fees.
Remember, everybody drives Crescent.
You should too.
Welcome back. It's Border Bash time. The annual rivalry celebration between University of South Carolina football fans and University of Georgia football fans will be held Friday at SRP Park in North Augusta this year. Walk to End Alzheimer's. The Walk to End Alzheimer's is scheduled for Saturday from 9 to 12 at Odell Weeks. Sunday Best. Be on the lookout for our Sunday Best feature on Diane Toole Miller, the owner of Crosby Miller School of Dance and artistic director of the Aiken Civic Ballet. To read more about these stories, please visit AikenStandard.com. I'm your host, Michelle Jackson, and I will see you next time on the front page.